The state Supreme Court heard arguments this week in a pair of lawsuits challenging an effort to repeal an historic tax hike package designed to give teachers a pay increase. The hearing came as school districts continue planning for the next school year, leaving some educators questioning whether the pay raises will ever happen.
Even as lawmakers approved House Bill 1010XX, a package of tax increases to fund teacher pay raises, an anti-tax group announced plans to circulate a petition calling for a vote of the people on the tax hikes.
So why are you guys doing this?
In our state constitution, it allows for a veto referendum.
Oklahoma Taxpayers Unite, fronted by former U.S. Senator Tom Coburn, formally launched their petition drive last month. The group wants voters to have a say on whether to repeal tax hikes on cigarettes, fuel, and energy production, which would be used to fund an average $6,100 teacher pay increase.
Is still intact.
Attorney Blake Sonny, representing professional Oklahoma educators, questioned whether the veto referendum is even allowed by the state constitution, which prohibits referendums for measures deemed necessary for the preservation of public safety.
Think about the importance of public schools in Oklahoma. I mean, obviously it's a major part of our state budget. It's a major part of communities across the state. And the court should recognize that, you know, when you have laws supporting for the support of public schools, that's part of that exception to referendum petitions.
Another challenge questioned the petition on its technical merits, claiming it was confusing to voters who might not understand what they were signing and failed to mention all the taxes. At a hearing Monday before the state Supreme Court, Chief Justice Douglas Combs appeared to agree with that assessment.
Mm-hmm. At best, to me, this is sloppy. Mm-hmm. And at worst, it's intentionally misleading. Mm-hmm. It's deceptive.
Oklahoma Taxpayers Unite attorney Barrett Bowers argued that while the petition may have contained some technical errors, that should not keep the repeal effort from moving forward.
There may be some things that could have been done better, but the court's opinions have said that's not the role of this court, is to find, could we have written it better, could we have done it better? It just simply doesn't amount to fraud or misleading the public or deception in this case.
Justice James Winchester questioned why the petition did not spell out the relationship between repeal of the tax hike package and teacher pay raises.
1010XX was passed for the explicit purpose of helping Oklahoma education. You don't want to tell the voters that their rejection or veto or repeal or approval might have an impact on that legislative desire?
But Bowers contends blocking tax hikes would not prevent pay increases for teachers.
We do not believe that 1010 is necessary for 1023 to go into effect. The repeal of 1010 will not result in the loss of the teacher pay raises.
Sonny claims that argument runs counter to lawmakers' intent.
We honestly can't sit here today and pretend that House Bill 1010XX was not specifically passed with the purpose to fund Oklahoma public education and the teacher pay raise bill, the support pay raise bill, the public education support bill. This is why the Oklahoma legislature included contingencies in all of those other bills.
And he says school officials also see the veto referendum as a direct threat to the pay raises.
School districts across Oklahoma right now are telling their teachers these raises don't go into effect. They're awaiting the outcome of this court and this protest.
But Bowers maintains pay increases could be paid for even if voters rejected the tax hike package.
I think it would be funded, as we can see currently, that we're going to have a significant surplus in the state and that our receipts for the past month, May and June, are expected to be some of the highest ever.
That view is not shared by Oklahoma Education Association President Alicia Priest.
You can't project out next year and the year after that on what the tax or what the increase in revenues are based on the last couple of months.
Oklahoma State School Board Association Executive Director Sean Heim says if Oklahoma Taxpayers Unite gathers the nearly 42,000 necessary signatures to put the veto referendum on the ballot, it could put the tax hike measures on hold. That, in turn, could leave school districts on the hook for teacher pay raises without the tax revenue to pay for them.
If they are tied together, then the teacher pay raise has to be funded in full from the first day of school, from August 1st when it goes into effect, and schools would have to find the additional money that they wouldn't receive based on 1010 being put on hold from other revenue. So they would have to look at other areas to cut or reduce expenditures to fully fund the teacher pay raise.
Meanwhile, the uncertainty over the pay hikes is affecting efforts to attract and retain teachers. Heim says prospects of a pay raise gave a boost at first to teacher recruitment.
But the uncertainty is hurting schools because some teachers are saying, hey, it's just one more time where they promise us something and they pull the rug out from under. So we do have teachers across the state that are saying, I'm not going through this anymore. I'm leaving the state or leaving the profession.
Heim says school districts want the issue settled quickly so they can start signing teacher contracts and continue planning for the coming school year.